Virgo, you beautiful soul, you. How are you? My name is Alicia. Welcome. Welcome back. This is Empath Tarot, where spirit's messages directly correlate with being highly sensitive here on planet Earth. Now, in this reading, we will be pulling some messages that will help uncover any abundance blocks you might be experiencing at this time, money or love related. If there is a certain amount of money you would like to manifest into your beautiful life or that special somebody, go ahead, hit that like button and subscribe. If you're interested in receiving a personal reading with myself and spirit, all of the details will be down in the description box below, along with my husband. If you haven't yet, to check him out. He's over at 7D Tarot. And be sure to stick around until the end of this reading, because we will be pulling a final message from the universe. Okay, so essentially what needs to happen is we want to say forgiveness, but we want to say acceptance along with that, right? So acceptance and forgiveness. Here we have the forgiveness card. But it's really making me feel more of like an acceptance. Acceptance will allow you to forgive. At the end of the day, whenever we are holding on to pain, adversity, I did this wrong before. This person did this before, and we practice living our lives with this mistrust with ourselves, with others. And that builds, that starts to build up over time, and we become attached to things. And it's through those energetic attachments, because we are not forgiving and letting go, that we become very imprinted in who we think we are. And so we walk around like a stone almost. We're not free, we're not having fun, we're not creative, we're not expressing ourselves. We tend to obsess and overthink everything. We're just very controlly. And it's really all stems from just an inability to forgive. And so that forgiveness is coming forward. And so we ask you to dive a little deep into that one and just ask yourself, what are you holding on to? From a parent to a coworker, to whatever, right? But forgiveness will set you free always. And you have big things that are coming in for you, we see here. So in your recent past, we have the Queen of Wands and the Knight of Swords. That's huge. What do we have here in the present? Judgment and the Knight of Cups in reverse. Okay, so in your recent past, you were feeling pretty confident. You were feeling excited. You were feeling ambitious. You were feeling like you had all these ideas and you were ready to rock on and just move forward and crush it. And it just felt like things were, you're again, just really feeling yourself with that Queen of Wands, really confident energy. Now, whenever we're feeling this energetic excitement and this energy of really gusto and moving forward and that confidence, right? Sometimes we have a tendency to, again, react off of our emotional state. And then what that will do is take us away from really connecting to our spirit. So we will follow the emotion of ambition, other excitement. However, if we are not showing up to our lives in any situation, we want you to look at your relationships, your careers, whatever you do, whatever it is that you do, that's a garden. Me reading is a garden. Me exercising, a garden. Me eating, a garden, right? So anything that you do is a garden. And you always want to make sure that every garden that you tend to is how you're tending it the way you want to do it. You've planted the flowers you want to plant. You are fertilizing it the way that you want to. You have it arranged and organized the way that makes you feel happy and good inside, right? So everything that you do has to be nurtured the way that you want it to be. If when you're starting these new journeys in life and you have these new gardens that are showing up for you that you're realizing you want to nurture and take care of now, when the time comes where all of a sudden you're feeling a little less connected to it, maybe you're feeling more closed off and shut down towards it with that Knight of Cups in reverse, feeling like maybe it's not your calling, feeling like maybe you're not, you know, really heeding what you feel like you want to do, because that's what that feeling always feels like. Whenever we are overthinking and obsessing a situation, that basically what's happening is that we're really just not showing up and doing it the way we want to do it. We're worrying about it from a state of fear. So it's basically like, imagine you walk through a nice little beautiful white picket fence into this garden, and it has some weeds and it has some needing some tending, right? It needs to get watered and it's looking a little shriveled, right? And you walked in and thought, oh my God, there's bugs and there's weeds and everything's wrong. I don't get it. It's just, what's going to happen, right? The garden won't be nourished, right? It will continue to stay the same, right? But when you walk in through this beautiful white picket fence and you see the potential and you see, okay, so I see what it can be. Maybe I don't even see what it could be yet, but I do know that it needs to get weeded, clearly. It needs to be watered. Poor buggers need to get watered. And maybe a little fertilizer, sprucken them up a little bit. Sprucken, is that a word? Sprucken them up. And maybe some tender loving words they need, right? So it's never about stepping into any garden of your life in a state of worry or despair and overthinking it. Instead, just, what does it need right now, right? Tend to its needs. Tend to that garden's needs. So exercise. If you have an exercise routine and all of a sudden it's not feeling very good, you're like, this isn't working. I don't like this. I'm not happy. Okay, don't worry. Don't worry, because then there's something even better waiting for you. There's something, there's a way that you want to exercise or that is going to feel better for your body. And when you're like, okay, well, what I have been doing isn't working. So let's decode this, right? What have I learned from what I was going through, right? So what have I learned worked in the past? And let's open up now to receiving something better, right? Always what it is. So we don't want you to ever overthink your gardens, right? So this is your affirmation. I don't overthink my current situation. I don't overthink my current situation. Don't overthink it. And what if you step into that garden and you're like, oh, hell no, I don't even know where to start, then shut the gate, turn around, and go and do something that's easier for you that will clear your energy. Maybe cleaning your house. Maybe it is exercise if you're worried about your career or something, or thinking about your career, and you step into the garden, you're like, oh my God, I don't even know. Shut the gate. It's okay. You'll know, but go and clear some energy elsewhere, tend to another garden, and then come back and revisit maybe when things are a little bit more energetically clear. Or you could just dive in and be like, I'm just going to start with the weeds. That's all I'm going to do. Now, today, I'm just going to do the weeds, right? Give yourself peace and just give yourself little bits, right? You know, if you're like starting a health journey, it's like, I'm just going to focus on drinking more water. Today, I'm just going to drink 2 liters of water. That's what I'm going to focus on. Tomorrow, let's see what else shows up, right? So that's what it's about, is don't worry. Don't feel like you need to obsess. Don't feel like you need to overcomplicate things, right? Surrender. And whenever you feel like you are overthinking and you're hyper-emotional and you just don't even know where to go, that's where you would say, you know, I surrender to my soul. Spirit, lead me this day. Through this contrast, I'm learning experience and I am being guided forward. Thank you, Spirit, for always supporting me. I love you. I trust you. Something along those lines. Words that express that you're needing help, and the universe, your guides, always, always will be there for you, and you will receive ideas, and then just act on those ideas, act on those impulses, and then that's when clarity will be yours, right? And again, sometimes we need to just get our bodies moving. That's the one thing with us empaths is that, and us emotional beings, is that to sit and to think, what happens is we collect energy, right? Thinking is energy, so we sit and we think, and then what happens is we almost feel like we're cement, and then so doing anything literally feels like we're trying to like walk through a cement wall. Literally, this happened to me just the other day. I was sitting thinking about trying to figure out what the best way to implement multiple ways to exercise in a day is without it taxing me and with it benefiting my life. And I was really thinking about it, and then I was feeling stressed about it, and then I neglected other gardens that needed taking care of. And so I was just feeling really emotional. And then all of a sudden, because I wasn't doing the things I wanted to do, energy was collecting because I wasn't doing the things I wanted to do. I was overthinking, more energy collecting. I was just sitting on the couch. I just wanted to cry. That's how emotional I felt. I think I pretty much did cry because I was so emotional that just came out, right? I was just watching my horse training videos because that always soothes me, right? So I'm just watching my horse training videos thinking like, ah. And then, you know what? I had this impulse to go and make my husband's food. He had to go prepare some of his food. It was like moving cement, doing the easiest task ever. Felt like it was like my parent telling me that, you know, you're not going to go to summer camp. That's how bad it felt. I was like, what? Right? I have to go do this. And it was the easiest thing in the world. So basically, pushed through it, got that done, and then I got another impulse to like take out the garbages. Okay, I did that. Okay, more energy cleared, felt better, right? It's just about getting up and moving and doing something. Don't sit, think, don't dwell. It'll just collect energy. You'll feel like cement. It won't be easy. You just got to keep the energy moving. You got to do those things that, you know, feel heavy. But when you do them, oh, you feel so light. You feel so light, beautiful soul. And that's what we're feeling for you, is you are going to be feeling so light coming up here. You are going to be united and connected to this Ace of Pentacles, which is a new beginning. Definitely something that's going to feel stable, very grounded for you, very exciting. Again, clarity will be yours. So you're going to be receiving clarity on growth, on progression, on stability, right? And that Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles and Ace of Pentacles, that is abundance, that's success, that's stability, that's feeling very grounded. I mean, so basically where you're headed is, well, what happens when we feel grounded and stable? Everything is energetically aligned. So basically, you're going to be aligned with this new idea. It's going to feel very soothing for your soul. So you got nothing to worry about. You just, you know, first things first, right? Forgiveness and acceptance of where you are and who you are. And that leads to your manifestations coming to full fruition, right? So Just trust. Universe's message for you, beautiful soul, is time for a love fest. Ooh. Universe says, actually, everyone is reasonable. They just have their own reasons. And usually, it's worth trying to learn what they are to maximize a chance of a full-blown 60s-style psychedelic love fest, which is always a good thing. Groovy you, the universe. So, that being said, love. And live your life from a place of love. Because it will always serve you, and it will always give you to where you want to be. Remember, every garden you walk into is just you walking through a white picket fence and seeing the solutions that are necessary. Okay, it needs this, this, and this, right? Whenever we sit there and we think, oh, it just becomes overwhelming, we don't even want to start, right? So just keep it simple, keep it easy, one task at a time, right? And very soon that garden will be flourishing before you know it. We love you so much. We hope you enjoyed your reading. We hope there were messages in here for you. And if there was, like and subscribe. We truly appreciate you. Spirit loves you. I love you. And until our next reading, keep shining, baby.